your flowers grow. Now it's raining and all your petals turn to stone. I've been praying, turn around and see my rose, but you've
or not. So this is clearly the Justice Department taking issue with the way that the FBI launched and conducted their investigation of Michael Flynn, and they went to court today to basically throw out the case. Now, again, fascinating thing, having been in that court to watch Michael Flynn say, yes, in fact, he did lie about his interactions, phone conversations with the Russian, then Russian ambassador to the United States, which he apparently had lied about to the vice president of the United States. There was no issue that he did lie. And I'm going to tell you, this will be a major blow to the FBI, because one of the things the FBI has held as a major issue is that they want people to tell them the truth when they come and do an investigation. They believe it has a major impact on how cases unfold. And this will be a definitely a blow to the FBI.
A blow to the FBI. Pierre Thomas, thank you very much. A triumph for President Trump, who, as I say, has been railing against not just the special counsel's investigation of him, President Trump, but of the people who were involved. Once again, Michael Flynn, President Trump's first national security advisor, all the criminal charges against him being dropped by the Justice Department, even after Flynn had pled guilty, and in that plea answered the question of the judge, are you doing this freely? Were you entrapped? All that is gone. We'll have much more on this on World News Tonight with David Muir.
Some Israeli scientists, something called controlled avalanche, which is basically make sure that everybody who is vulnerable is protected, and then actually encourage people who are younger to not social distance. And you sort of mentioned something like this in your article for The Hill. So is that something that we should be seriously considering? Just saying, if you're under the age of 40 and you're healthy, you should go out, you should go to ball games. And if you get coronavirus and then you get over it, then you have actually added to the health of the country.
Ben, this is really hitting the nail on the head, sort of, with the basic premise of immunology and decades of knowledge about viruses. It's actually a negative to interfere by total isolation with herd immunity. Herd immunity is necessary, and it is the most immediately available way to break the connections toward the vulnerable in this contagious sort of disease. So it's actually detrimental to lock everybody up and prevent the low-risk groups, like you're saying, to get the disease. 50% of people are zero symptoms. Over 95% of people, probably 99% of people, have very mild disease. There's nothing wrong with that in the low-risk groups. The focus should be preventing the people who are the vulnerable. We know who they are. It's harmful to prevent mingling by other people.